Hello? Hi. We are starting off this shebang with Guile's theme from Street Fighter. It is a jazz arrangement, and there are going to be many solos, so hold on to your hats.
Thank you. Hi, I am Alex Ryan. I'm the president of the Gamer Symphony Orchestra. Now, I'm curious, how many of you are familiar with our shows? You are perhaps veterans of our concert. Very nice. How many of you were perhaps dragged here by a somewhat more enthusiastic person? Maybe you're not as familiar with our stuff. Don't worry, I think you're in for a treat either way. For those of you less familiar with us, we are the first collegiate-level ensemble to pull a repertoire purely from video game music. This performance actually marks the 7th anniversary of our first performances. Back then, we were about 15 to 20 people performing in, like, I think the first performance was in, like, the food court of the student union or something. We've come a bit of a way from there, which is nice. And we've been student-run the entire time. Everything you see here has been put together by volunteers, and it's a pretty astounding operation considering the vast majority of us are doing this pretty much in our free time. So this past year has been very good to us. We had a very successful fundraiser earlier this year, which allowed us to procure a new tuba. Has unfortunately not been without a great loss. Last December, we lost our beloved tuba player, David Scher. There's a bio in the program, which I encourage you all to read. He's remembered today by an empty seat in the low brass section, and the concert today is dedicated to his memory. All right, so without further ado, I bring you guys the Gamer Symphony Orchestra.
Kara Levitsky, and I am the conductress of this orchestra. I was playing the flute earlier and you didn't notice, so. With that being said, the next piece that we are going to play is called Banjo-Kazooie. It was written by David Scher, a tuba player of ours, who we lost a few months ago. This piece really represents David and who he was as a person. And while it hurt us very deeply to lose him, today we are going to celebrate his life by playing his first ever played arrangement of Banjo-Kazooie. We have Noah on the banjo, I know, and it's going to be very exciting, so enjoy.
Thank you. a new face on the block, I guess. So this Kevin Mock is our assistant conductor for this semester, so we've been working with him to eventually take our place here at the podium. So they're going to be playing Super Mario World credits, which is another of David Scherer's compositions.
Thank you.
Okay, this next piece we're going to play. How many of you have played Skyrim? All right, sounds good. All right, well, we're gonna fast forward ourselves into a frenzy here. So I hope you enjoy Dragonborn.
Oh!
Thank you. I'm glad you enjoyed that. We are now going to have a 15-minute intermission. Please feel free to take this time to look in your program. There's a part on the back that you can fill out as the concert goes along. And we are so happy to have you here today. So hope to see you in 15 minutes.
So to start the second half, we're going to do something a little different. A few months ago, Victor came to me and he said, hey, I want to play this piece that has a whistle in it. And I was like, okay. But so we listened to it and we put this together, and this is, I guess, the only thing you could find in video games that features a whistle, so. And that's what he's good at, so. This is Protoman's Whistle Game. Thank you.
Is it still on? It is still on. That's wonderful. Hi there.
Hi.
Hi there. So, my name is Joel Gutman. I'm the current Vice President of the Gamer Symphony Orchestra. First bit of business, we do allow non-flash photography and other recording, but please no flash photography. Photography can distract people up here, so thank you very much for that. And have you guys been enjoying the first half of the show? We really love what we do, and to be honest, we'd do it even if you guys didn't like it, but it is nice that you enjoy it as well. So, if you go to school at someplace other than Maryland, there was a Gamer Symphony Orchestra there. Raise your hand if you would want to be in a Gamer Symphony Orchestra at your school. I see you. I see you. I see you. I see you. I see someone up there, and I've tricked all of you. Haha, I tricked all of you. Because now I get to challenge you to start a GSO at your school. You're locked into it now because you raised your hand. Because, you see, although we were the first Gamer Symphony Orchestra, we are no longer the only Gamer Symphony Orchestra. There are Gamer Symphony Orchestras at the University of Delaware. We actually have people from their, what they call the 8-bit orchestra here as well. Where are you guys? There they are. They go. There are also people from Ithaca College in upstate New York who have started the Gamer Symphony Orchestra. I don't think any of them were able to make it here today, but they are with us in spirit. There are also people at Towson who will be starting one next year, and we're currently in talks with people at Montclair State University in New Jersey who are looking to start a Gamer Symphony Orchestra. So, all of you out there, just raise your hands. You can do it, because we will help you. We can give you guidance, we can give you sheet music, make it so you don't have to reinvent the wheel. So, look on the back of your programs. No, seriously, look on the back of your programs. There's an email address there. Get in touch with us, and we will help you. Because, who knows, fast forward a few years, you might have this. You never know until you try. So, speaking of just growth and really awesome things, who here has played a little game called Journey? For those of you who haven't, it is a truly beautiful, beautiful game. It's based on just a very simple, simple concept of walking towards a mountain. It's that simple, but it is incredibly beautiful. It has a beautiful soundtrack. And although for us saying that something has a beautiful soundtrack isn't that out of the ordinary, this time around, the general public actually took a bit of notice because for the first time, a game score, the entire album, was nominated for a Grammy Award. So this was a big thing for video game music as a whole. So the composer, Mr. Austin Wintory, actually worked with us last year when we played a piece from a game that he did called Flow, and we wanted to work with him again this year for a Journey. And he was like, you know, I'd really love to come out and see it. Trouble is, sadly, we don't have that money. However, there's a group on campus called Kappa Kappa Psi, they're the honorary band fraternity, who helped to put forward the money to make it so he could come down. He did a seminar, actually, last night, which was truly, truly amazing. We're going to have video up soon online, so you can see that as well. But it means that Austin Wintory is here with us today. So, ladies and gentlemen, Grammy nominee Mr. Austin Wintory.
Thank you so much for having me. You guys, you were so awesome. It's so much fun to now twice be able to sit and listen with you. And where is Victor? Good Lord, man. I am so pissed I didn't have whistling in Journey. Holy crap, I wasn't prepared for that. I was very distracted just now. I don't want to sit here and waste time and get in their way. I'm fond of saying that composers have the world's best and most useless job because they're the ones who actually make the music. No one has ever heard a piece of music that a composer wrote. You only heard what a performer then did with it. And so it's always a real joy when musicians want to actually reach out to you and engage with what you're doing, because being a composer entails sitting in a room, you know, like about this size, no windows, and trying to seal out the outside world to try to kind of hear yourself thinking. And so when a hand reaches in, it's like, hey, come to DC, we're gonna play some music. It's kind of mind-blowing. So, that's why I'm actually convinced that none of this is real, none of you are real. I'm just kind of in some sort of catatonic state right now in a room somewhere with blinking equipment surrounding me, because it's a little too good to be true. So, thank you guys again so much for having me here, for playing this stuff. Nothing ever trumps passion when it comes to music making. And these guys have it in kind of like explosive, hard to contain amounts, which is good because it's a really bad thing to try to contain it. So, I am going to get out of your way. Thank you for welcoming me here. It's really an immense honor. And I'm going to turn it over to these guys.
So, it was an honor, Austin, to get to work with you on writing this piece. Thank you so much. Let's see. And so I thank you, ladies. Thank you so much. You put so much effort and work into that. Thank you so much. All right. The next piece that we are going to play is a little bit different, just a little bit. And it's called Concerto from Donkey Kong 64.
Thank you.
So one of my first video game memories was when I was about 9, and when everyone was getting their N64s, and my friend said, "Hey, I rented this great game." And I went over to his house to play it, and he kept beating me because he knew how to grab, and I didn't know what button it was. Until he told me, like, an hour later. I was like, oh, okay. I don't know why I told you that story. But the game was Super Smash Brothers, the original. And so we're going to play a medley of the games that I think universally are like one of the most played games that people, as you said, like, to anyone between the age of 15 and 25, say, like, Smash? They're like, yeah.
Thank you.
has been a really great semester as far as getting recognition for being an orchestra that plays video game music. So we have a piece from Journey from before, and then last fall, David Arkenstone from Blizzard approached us to kind of make an arrangement from World of Warcraft. So this is... Alex is going to say a few things first.
So before we get to that, I have a handful of people to thank and also a few things to mention. As Kira mentioned before, there is a feedback form. Bye, Jacob. He'll be back. There's a feedback form in the back of your programs, and it's really helpful if you guys all fill that out and then put that in the little box we have up front out in the lobby. Those help us give us feedback about what kinds of things you all want to hear, because at the end of the day, we wouldn't be doing this if no one came to hear us. Also, there are instructions about donating. We do get a small portion of our operating costs from the student government, but that only covers 20 to 30%. Venues like this cost a small fortune, so we all have to make it up either through donations from our members or from our audience. So if you all would consider donating just even a few bucks from, you know, even like $5 from everyone here would cover our operating costs for like a year, so it would mean a whole lot to us. Also, if you write checks to the College Park Foundation, as indicated on the back of the program, you can actually get a tax deduction, so that's cool. So there's a few people I want to thank. First, obviously, the house staff and the tech crew for making this all happen behind the scenes. Our audio recorder, Antonino. Recordings from this concert will all be posted to our website in probably a few weeks to maybe a month. All of our past repertoire is also on our website, so be sure to check that out. It's all available for free. I would again like to thank Austin Wintery for coming out and doing a cool little seminar last night, and also contributing the arrangement of the Journey for this concert. And of course, I'd like to thank Captain Hamasai for making it possible to bring him out. I would like to thank all of the officers and arrangers who within the group who make this all possible. I mean, like I mentioned before, this is all student-run, so everything is kind of built from the ground up by the active members here, including all the music you've heard. I would also like to thank a couple major contributors to our fundraising efforts from earlier this year. And those thanks go out to a few people in particular. A good number of them are listed in the program, but a few distinguished ones are Joseph Tran, Vanessa Martinez, Linda Wellen, Don Kober, Laura Albanese, and myself. I was like, what's my name on it? Oh, right. I'd also like to recognize two individuals personally who, on up guys, who donated equal to or over $1,000. So that is not a small amount of money. That's a big amount of money. Johnny dropped an amazing 1,600. Dang. Thank you. I guess the only question I have is, I mean, not really why, but what do you guys see in us? Like, why? What? Okay, yeah, I am asking why.
So I heard about you guys at MAGFest a year or two ago, and I thought this is really awesome. You know, I wish I had this when I was in college, and I've always enjoyed playing video game music by myself, but that's not a lot of fun. You know, like this, that's fun. And so you guys need a tuba, and you know, that's a foundation to a music group like this. I thought it'd be a good way to help the arts.
So for me, it's a pretty different story. You have to excuse the power, I just came from Coast Guard duty. But it was actually a happenstance. I was working on a friend's movie campaign for Indiegogo, and all of a sudden I saw video game, Gamer Symphony Orchestra. I was actually taking classes at Maryland at the time, still am, sort of. But, you know, 15 years ago, I was sitting in, as a musician for the first time, stuck with a recorder. And, why do I bring that up? Well, just that same year was also my first experience with video games. Game of choice was Knights, or as it's formally called, Knights into Dreams. And this is what, this is really what it's all about. Wow, it'd be great if someone, you know, put these out, if you could perform these, went to the band director every year. How about these? Never worked. But that was always one part of it. And then all of a sudden, I found out, you know, there is a group that does perform it and want to see it grow. And especially when they mentioned tuba, I'd always been fascinated with heavier and deeper instruments. I went from clarinet, kind of forced into that, alto sax, tenor sax, baritone sax, you know, bass, guitar, piano. All of a sudden I found bassoon. Tried to get a kind of bassoon, and that's the first time actually seeing one. But didn't have 8,000 for one. But it's great to see this year. I'm actually a University of Delaware alumni. 8-bit orchestra, I didn't know about that back then, but it looks like I'll have two orchestras to attend concerts too.
Certificates of appreciation signed by most, if not all, of the orchestra. A little messy, but you know, it's just our little way of sending our thanks to you guys. All right. So for this finale piece, as Jacob was in the process of mentioning, when I rudely cut him off, this resulted from a collaboration. Between one of the many composers who actually worked on the score of World of Warcraft and one of our arrangers as well. This medley represents just a tiny slice of World of Warcraft's soundtrack, but I think it's a pretty good slice. So without further ado, this is our World of Warcraft medley.
Thank you.
I have been in this orchestra for 5 years. Last year, I believe, at the Smithsonian concert, and the semester before, I was the only conductor. And I just want to tell you that you have meant more to me in my life than anything. And I am so, so honored that I get to stand here before you today at my last concert with you. And I'm trying not to leak at the moment. So, you are my heart, you are my soul. Every single one of you is important to me throughout the years. Please raise your hand if you're also, this is your last semester with the GSO. There are many of us leaving. This orchestra, including me, but we will always cherish for the rest of our lives, and I will definitely, definitely be telling hopefully any children that I have about you all and all the stupid crazy things we did together. So we are doing an encore at my request. The first piece I ever wrote with the GSO was Shadow of the Colossus. It got rejected 3 times, actually. But that was because I didn't play the game all the way through. And then I got to the end, and I was like, oh, that's why. And so I fixed it, and we've played it, what, like 15 times since then? Something like that. And every time we don't play it, they still have the sheet music, and they're like, can we play it? And I'm like, oh, maybe next semester. So I'd like to thank you for letting me have the chance of this last time conducting you all on this piece. And I love you all so much, and thank you. Shout out to Carlson.